more song for y'all because I'm always obligated to play this because God bless George Strait. He made me happy, Mama happy, and the IRS man all at the same time. And he built a lovely fence between me and a kind of creepy neighbor. So we love George Strait. Say God bless George wherever he is. But and then you're gonna have the blessing. I'm getting to hear my old friend Clint Daniels. And I have to tell this, Clint, I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to tell this funny little story. When we both got our first record deals, he can't believe I'm telling this, but he'll tell you in a minute it's true, because he was hiding from me. We both had our record deals at the same time, and I was in the middle of recording my first record for Warner Brothers, and Clint was in the middle of recording his first record for Arista. Arista, right, Clint? Is it Arista?
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway, I had a song that the head of my label had come in and heard this one song and said, that's the first single, that's what we want. And so we were really working hard on it, and it was a big deal. We were spending a lot of money. I'm talking about $5,000 or $6,000 a song. So it was a lot of money. And someone in my camp, we'll just put it like that, in case this gets on the internet. Someone in my camp took my songs and started pitching them to other people that were also recording at the same time. Because someone in my camp didn't think I was about to kick a butt. But anyway, they take my song and it winds up over at Arista for Clint Daniels. And I call my friend Wynn Varble, and I don't know if y'all know Wynn or not, he's crazier than me, he's from Georgia. And I said, Wynn, have you heard about this guy, Clint Daniels? He goes, well, yeah, Leslie, he's a good guy. I go, I'm about to kill him. And he goes, why? I go, he's got my song, and he's fixing to record it. And he goes, now, Leslie, he's a good boy. I said, he's going to be a dead boy, because he ain't cutting my song. I said, the label, this is fixing to be the first single. And he goes, well, you can't do that, Leslie. You have to be proper. You can't call out people. And I'm not like that. I'm Baptist. And I was mad. And it was a big deal, you know. And I said, I've got to kill this guy. Where is he? He said, you can't do that, Leslie. I said, well, I'll call the record label. So I called his record label and got this guy on the phone that I've known for a long time. I said, hey, blah, blah, it's Les Satcher. Have you got my song, you know, going down hard over there? And he goes, well, now, Leslie. And I'm like, I'm going to be there in 10 minutes, Clint. Boy, I went working up. They were all gone. Their office was locked up. I'm saying that happened. Anyways, Clint, who I did not know, went ahead and cut the song, but it was okay because it was a great cut because he's amazing and you're going to hear it. But I still didn't like him for a long time. Then I took him as a brother and I loved him to pieces. And thankfully, he forgave me for being so, you know, nasty. I still feel 25. I still raise a little cane with this old boy. Honky tonks on city limits. But man, I'm still right there and I'm singing above the crowd. And the noise, Clint, come sing. Sometimes I feel like Jesse James.
The truth about him is that a damn door
never really tells
the whole truth.
It don't read between the lines.
Can't read what's inside. It's really something. What?
No reflection of the truth of my youth.
That's right. Sometimes I feel like Jesse James.
When I rode in on
I'll be an old troubadour. You bet your ass.
And I'm gone. Cliff Daniels.